yoga benefits the body in the following ways. Yoga improves digestion, circulation and immunity. Yoga enhances function of neurological and endocrine organs. Yoga prevents and provides relief from chronic illness. Overall, the body feels healthier and more energetic. As we know, diabetes are two types, type 1 and type 2. In case of type 1 diabetes, there is no production of insulin. But in case of type 2 diabetes, pancreas does not produce insulin. So, some poses of the yoga in strengthen regulate the pancreas to produce the insulin. Let's see which yogas are beneficial for the patients of the diabetes.
First is Kapalbhati or Skull Shining Breathing Technique. Kapalbhati, press your stomach inward and forcefully breathe out. The Skull Shining Breathing Technique helps energize the nervous system and rejuvenates brain cells. It is very helpful for patients suffering from diabetes as it stimulates abdominal organs. Kapalbhati improves blood circulation in the abdominal organs. So, in this way, it activates the pancreas to produce the insulin. 5 minutes morning and 5 minutes evening, twice in a day. Seated forward bend or Paschimottanasana. The two legs forward bend massages and tones the abdominal and pelvic organs. This asana helps people suffering from the diabetes. It balances the prana in the body and also calms the mind. Do it twice in a day, 5 minutes morning and 5 minutes evening. Now, Mandukasana. Sitting in a Vajrasana posture, close the fist of the both hands. While pressing the navel with the both fist, exhale and bend forward. Keep looking straight. Stay in this position for some time and then come back to Vajrasana posture. Repeat this position 3 to 4 times. Tejasana activates pancreas. As a result, there is a quantity of insulin produced in the body. Now, in Mandukasana 2, we are doing with the palm. This asana beneficial in stomach problems. It is beneficial for heart disease. It strengthens the pancreas, intestine, liver, kidneys. Woman strengthens the uterus. It reduces the fat from stomach, waist and buttocks. Next, sitting half spinal twist. Sit in Dandasana pose. Fold the left leg and place the ankle near the hips. Right leg toward the outside of the left knee on the ground. With breathe in, the right hand and the back. Backward. Stay in this position for some time. Look forward with exhale. Sitting half spinal twist massages the abdominal organs, increases the oxygen supply to the lungs, beneficial in diabetes and backache, bad blood circulation in all nerves, veins situated around the spine, cures the stomach disorder, strengthen pancreas and intestines. Going to do Gomukhasana. Lift the left hand and bend it back and take the right hand behind the back to hold the left hand. Keep the neck and back straight. Repeat it to the other side. to do bow pose or dhanurasana. The bow pose strengthen, regulate the pancreas. This pose is highly recommended people with diabetes. Dhanurasana also strengthen abdominal muscles. It is a good stress and fatigue buster. Do it twice in a day, 5 minutes morning, 5 minutes evening. Dhanurasana strengthen the pancreas to produce the proper amount of insulin. In this way, it is helpful to cure the diabetes. Next, cobra pose or bhujangasana. Bhujangasana also activates the pancreas to produce the insulin. In this way, this asana strengthens and regulates the pancreas. Now, half-length gas-releasing pose. This asana improves the digestion, circulation, immunity. So, activate the pancreas to produce the insulin. The lying down body twist. Lying down body twist massages the internal organs, improves digestion, strengthen, regulate the pancreas to produce the proper amount of insulin. This posture also exerts pressure on the abdominal organs. It is helpful for the patients of the diabetes. Wait in other side. Final resting yoga pose, Shavasana. Practicing Shavasana in between other asanas relieves the tiredness of the body in very short span of the time and helpful to balance all the hormones.